My name's Luke Weaver. I'm a PhD candidate at the University of Washington, studying with Greg Wilson in the biology department there. I was able to come down to the UCMP thanks to the Samuel P. and Doris O. Wells Fund. And so that funded my travel, my stay to the collections. And my reason for coming was that the UCMP has one of the best collections of fossil mammals from what's known as the Judithian time period. So I'm describing a fauna from an early late Cretaceous locality, and then some really nice complete material of multituberculate specimens from a locality that's coeval with this Judith River material. It's the Two Medicine Formation, and we have some like complete skeletons and skulls and dentitions of a multituberculate that I'll be describing there. So my reasoning for coming here was both to compare the Judith material to those materials, and then also to take different linear measurements on different aspects of the teeth and note certain characteristics of their morphology to help a broader project, which is aiming to understand the relationships between some of the earliest groups of the multituberculates that later in the Cretaceous go on to be the most dominant, both in number of species and as far as kind of ecological diversity in the later Cretaceous and into the early Paleogene as well. So basically measuring teeth and taking lots of notes and pictures as well. So basically multituberculate mammals, they're the longest lived order of mammals. They show up in the fossil record of about the middle Jurassic, and they persist until the end of the Eocene, so a span of about 166 to 35 million years. And what they're characterized by these really funky teeth. So they have molars that have a bunch of little bumps arranged in kind of longitudinal rows, and they have a big fourth premolar on their lower jaw that is shaped kind of like a buzzsaw. So multituberculate literally means multiple tubercles, so many bumps, essentially. They're an extinct lineage, so they were by far the most abundant and diverse group of mammals in the late Cretaceous, but they're now extinct. Their closest relatives is often debated, but and so multituberculates are essentially sitting phylogenetically between the placentals and marsupials, which we call therian mammals, and the monotremes. So they're kind of in between there. And there's a bunch of other Mesozoic mammal groups which kind of fall on that gradient between those two major living groups. So what you're looking at when you see these seas of corks is basically they're the backsides of pinned teeth. So Mesozoic mammals, as a rule, are very small. And so the best way to be able to observe the morphology, take measurements, and so on, is to have them mounted to little pins like this, and that way I can manipulate it under the microscope and really look at the morphology. And it's been really fun to dig into these collections because they were collected in large part in the 70s and early 80s, and a lot of the stuff was worked up and published on in the late 80s, early 90s, and much of it hasn't been touched since. And so in addition to these already pinned teeth and things that have been cataloged, I've also been going through and looking through little boxes like this, which you can see are chock full of little bits of bones and teeth. And so part of what I've done while I've been here is sorting through these sorts of amalgamations of bones and teeth and picking out research quality specimens, or at least specimens that are able to be identified to a specific taxon. That way they can be cataloged within the larger system. And then one kind of fun thing that's a testament to just how old some of this material was and when it was last being studied is there are these film photographs that were taken of various specimens in the collection. And many of them look like they were multituberculates, like what I'm studying, but then some of them also look like tiny teeth of marsupial relatives that are also really common in this fauna. So it just goes to show that that it's these are old collections, and it's been a blast being able to bring them back to life again.